Okay, so we'll start with this. So this is Ewing sarcoma. Okay, so Ewing sarcoma is a sarcoma. Okay, which is malignant in nature. Okay, I will just show you a slide and then we'll come back. Okay, so see, this is so its full form of Ewing sarcoma is. So this is my hostel. Okay, so we have a hostel in Mumbai. It is Ewing. Okay, so there's a Ewing, B wing, Ewing. So it is Ewing. Okay, so this hostel is Ewing. Okay, or as per hostel. Okay, so this is a hostel. The guys who live there are all like round obese young kids, 15, 18. Okay, so all this young kids singing with their mics. Okay, and so we'll start again with Ewing sarcoma. So Ewing sarcoma is characteristically malignant tumors in children's. Okay, so Ewing sarcoma, I usually say it's Ewing sarcoma. It is because of some translocation, 1122 translocation is there. Okay, it is more common in males. It have an onion skin appearance. Okay, and it is more common in diaphysis. So it's, I think male officer would give him justice by E of male officer. Okay, chemo, radiation and radiotherapy. We'll cut it short. Okay, so now start with this. So it is a primary malignant round cell tumor. So as I show you, every kids in the Ewing is a round. Okay, so obese. So round cell tumor. They derive from, so round cell tumor. So these three words. Okay, so round cell. Okay, these three words are interrelated. So round cell. This is primitive neuroectoderm, and this is pinnate family. Okay, these three things are related to each other. सो जो नेट फैमिली होता है प्रिमिटिव न्यूरो एक्टोडर्म इसको बोलते हैं फुल फॉर्म इज पी नेट का फुल फॉर्म क्या है प्रिमिटिव न्यूरो एक्टोडर्म सो प्रिमिटिव न्यूरो एक्टोडर्म से डराइव होता है दिस ऑल आर राउंड सेल ट्यूमर्स ओके यंग मेल्स होता है 10 to 15 ईयर्स यंग किड्स डायफाइसिस फीमर शाफ्ट ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू एवरीथिंग इन फीमर शाफ्ट एंड ट्रिगर ओके देन दिस इज ईविंग और दिस इज This is a gene, which is a MYC2 gene, bolte isko, ya CD99 bolte, okay? So this all seems very complicated. I will try to solve it. Okay, I will try to go ahead. So this thing of this is a hostel. Okay, Ewing mein idhar. So in Ewing there is 11 rooms. Okay, so we have this type of hostel. Okay, so as a it's a U-shaped hostel. So our hostel was aisa ek floor aisa tha, then एक फ्लोर ऐसा था एंड देन इट्स ऐसा था सो इन वन फ्लोर देयर इज 11 रूम्स ओके 11 रूम्स पर रूम देयर इज टू स्टूडेंट्स सो 22 सो इट्स लाइक 11 रूम्स एंड देयर इज 22 स्टूडेंट्स सो इट इज अ ट्रांसलोकेशन ऑफ 1122 ओके ऑल यंग किड्स स्टे इन द हॉस्टल ऑल आर ओबीज दे आर ईटिंग ऑनियन पिज्जा एंड व्हाटएवर दे कैन हैव दे यूजुअली ईट दिस ओके नाउ सो सी दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इमेज सो ईविंग Ewing, okay, 11 rooms, 22 students. So 1122 translocation is there. Okay, all students of that hostel passed except one or two. Okay, so except one who score highest. So it is a CD99. So I got a CD99 of that round body. Okay, and all hostelites are of a similar family. Okay, so it's like a one family that is Pinit family. Okay, MYC2 gene. So I had already shown you that Mike. ओके सो MYC2 जीन होता है उसमें एविंग्स में ओके नाउ दे कैन ईट एनीथिंग सो ओनियंस देन पिज्जा ग्लाइकोजन डायस्टेज ऑल ईटिंग सब्सटेंसेस ओके एंड द होम इज राइट फॉर देम सो दे आर दे फील लाइक ए होम ओके एंड ऑल आर क्यूट लाइक दिस पांडा ओके ऑन ऑल मेल्ट्स लाइक ए स्नो ओके विल गो अहेड एंड विल अगेन सी दिस सो द एविंग सार्कोमा द एक्चुअली द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक पिक्चर इज ऑफ दिस ओनियन टाइप ऑफ स्किन ओके So there is a periosteal reaction. So periosteum pe reaction hota hai. This type of reaction occurs, which looks like a onion skin. So Ewing sarcoma characteristic finding is this onion skin appearance. Okay. One more characteristic of Ewing sarcoma is this Homer right pseudo rosette. So kya hota hai? Histology mein if you see, so it looks like a Homer right pseudo rosette. You don't know what is Homer right pseudo rosette. Even I don't know what is Homer right pseudo rosette. But it is a characteristic. So you had to. You have to mug it up anyway. So it's like a home is very right for these kids. Okay. So this characteristic is Homer right rosettes. Okay. Now glycogen and past positive. Okay, so other thing is, so all are rounded blue cells. So see this, all rounded blue cells are there. Undifferentiated round blue cells are there. Okay. So this is very important in Ewing's. This microscopic is very important. In other tumors, I had not shown you the microscopic, but in Ewing's, microscope is very important. So you just see this all of eating substance. So glycogen, obviously. Then diastase is something which helps in your pepsin. It's like a pepsin. It for helps in digestion. Okay, and home is right. Okay, and this is past. So it's like all kids in Ewing Hostel, all young kids, 10 to 15 male hostel. Okay, 10 to 15 years male hostel. All young kids, they can eat anything like pizza, onion pizza. They can eat glycogen. They can eat diastase. Okay, now they all are of same family, round cell family. Okay, peanut family. Then they feel it like a home. They feel it like a home. So Homer, right, Rosette is there. Okay, and they all live near to each other. So all are like pass. So all your MCQ will be solved in one mnemonic. Okay, onion skin appearance. Sometimes these two appearances are also there. Sunray appearance and Codman triangle. See what happens is there's a periosteal reaction. So periosteal reactions occur like an onion skin. Okay. But in some cases, it can have like sunburst appearance. Okay, it can have that sunburst and Codman's triangle. But this is characteristic of osteosarcoma. But in some cases of Ewing, it can present. Okay, so it's just for your purpose. But if they had asked characteristic, so Sunray and Codman triangle is a characteristic of osteosarcoma. In Ewing, sometimes it may be found. Okay, but in Ewing's, onion skin is the most important. So again we'll go and again we'll see this. Okay, so now see this. So and you usually give the chemo and radio sensitive to Ewing sarcoma. So Ewing sarcoma mein kya karte hum log, what is the treatment? It is a chemo radiotherapy. As soon as you give chemotherapy, everything melts like a snow. Okay, so this round pandas melt like a snow. Okay, so they are very cute and they melt like a snow. So again we'll see. So 1122 translocation, you understand? 11 room 22 students, okay, males, okay, onion skin, okay, chemotherapy melting, okay, round cell, same family, peanut family, Mike. So they sing like this. One of the student all pass. Okay, so all student passed in exam, so they are pass positive except one which scored 99. So CD99, so CD99 ho gaya, MYC2 ho gaya. Okay, CD99, MYC2, peanut family, 1122 translocation, young females, round cell. Okay, this think of having. Okay, so yeah, I don't think isme kuch bacha. Home is right for them. So Homer, right, rosettes is there. All cute, so melts like snow. Okay, so see this is a cute person. Okay, then Homer, right, rosette is Homer, right, rosette. Okay, theek hai. Now go ahead with this X-ray, glycogen pass, diastase sensitive, ye sab ho gaya. So now, so differential diagnosis. Okay, so Ewing's is mainly differential with osteomyelitis. Okay, so osteomyelitis ka ek DD mein Ewing's aata hai. If you don't remember, it's okay, nothing big thing. Now, so this is important. So in Ewing's sarcoma, okay, is there any issue in? Okay, no issue. Okay, so in Ewing sarcoma, the treatment is not surgical. Okay, so most of the treatment is mainly chemotherapy. So whenever you give chemo, it melt like a snow. Okay, so sab kuch melt ho jata hai. They are very cute, so they melt like snow, and then you can do surgery or radiosensitive. But this thing you should remember, that is highly radiosensitive and it melt like snow. Okay, so this thing is important. Okay. Now prognostic indicators. So these are the prognostic indications. So any tumor with high size is bad, increased age is bad, metastasis bad. This fever, yes, are LDH high. Okay, so this thing you should remember. So anything which have a fever, high ESR, LDH, that means the inflammation is high. Okay, so ESR, LDH, fever, these all are inflammatory markers. So whenever they are high, that means that problem is higher. Okay. So the prognosis is worse. Okay, that's why, because of this hole, this it's also look like osteomyelitis. Because in osteomyelitis you have the same thing, ESR, LDH, fever high. So sometimes you get confused with osteomyelitis. So DD of Ewing's is osteomyelitis. Okay, so this thing is common sense. Okay, so these are high, that means prognosis is worse. Okay, so we I think we had finished Ewing sarcoma. Okay, now this come with this chondroblastoma. Okay, so chondroblastoma mein kya hota hai? So we'll consider again with chondro means cartilage, blastoma is it is a type of tumor. Okay, so chondro means immature cartilage cells ka. So cartilage cells ka ye tumor hota hai. Okay, in a skeletally immature young age mein hota hai, 10 to 20. So in, it's like OCB and JCB. Okay, so this is chondroblastoma. It is an epiphysis. So epiphysis mein you see this one. Okay, so ye epiphysis mein hota hai. So this is immature cells. Okay, now if you see jab bhi if you see any cartilaginous tumor na, you will see this type of appearance. Ye jo appearance hota hai na, isko kya bolte hai? Mottled bolte hai, mottling bolte hai. Mottling matlab kya hota hai? Thoda irregular hota hai. It's like a irregular, it's not a definite aisa. So it like a उलन बॉल को तुमने डाल दिया है बोन के अंदर. सो दे आर वेरी ऐसा इंटरमिंगल्ड टाइप का अपीयरेंस होता है. ओके, सो एनी कार्टिलेज ट्यूमर यू विल सी दिस टाइप ऑफ अपीयरेंस. ओके, इट इज नॉट अ बोन ट्यूमर, मतलब इट इज अ कार्टिलेजनस ट्यूमर. ओके, सो विल अगेन गो अहेड. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ अपीयरेंस यू सी मॉटलिंग. दिस इज नॉट, आई एम जस्ट पुट इट व्हाट मींस मॉटलिंग मींस क्या होता है. सो मॉटलिंग मींस समथिंग इरेगुलर. ओके, दिस इज नॉट स्किन अपीयरेंस of this tumor. It is a, what do you mean by mottled and what do you mean by stippled? So stippled means this type of stippling hota hai. Okay, so ye stipple hota hai means irregular, kabhi big and sometimes small, and this is you mean by mottling. So in OCB, in CB, that chondroblastoma, you have stippled. In if in x-ray you see this one, you have a stippled calcification or mottling of appearance. Okay, and well defined the lesion in epiphysis. Okay, so I had make a mnemonic. I don't know why I am making this, but it's like I am CB. CB is a chondroblastoma, not BC. So if you are like ABCD, okay, so this is a very regular pattern. Okay, ABCD, but you just reverse it. It's like a CB. CB is not a pattern. So I am CB, not BC. So I have a tendency to be weird, immature, distorted, mottled. So it's a very irregular pattern. So CB is a very weird, not regular. So BC is regular, ABCD is regular, opposite is not regular. So you just remember in CB, that chondroblastoma, iska matlab hai ki thoda ajeeb hai. So it has some mottling appearance, stipple class calcification. Okay, then obviously you have OCB ke through, you know it is epiphyseal tumor. Okay, now this is most important. In if you go in the histology, chicken wire or picket fence calcification hota hai. So this you had put this one. So ye dekho, this jo chicken ko rakhte hain, that cage. So this is the chicken wire cage or picket fence, ye bolte hain. So this type of calcification is found in CB. So CB, jab bhi aaye word CB, chondroblastoma, you have to remember one thing. OCB, okay, it is epiphyseal tumor. The second thing you have to remember, CB is not regular, so it is a very weird. So mottling hoga, stippled calcification hoga, wo chicken wire ki tarah thoda ajeeb sa hoga. Okay, so that thing you should remember. Okay, treatment is you curettage and bone grafting, so nothing big. Okay, so chondroblastoma mein I think this much is there. Okay, mottled, stippled, males and all that. And it is obviously it is irregular, weird, so it is immature cartilage cell, skeletal. Okay, now you come to chondrosarcoma. So what is chondrosarcoma? Is what? So this C is chondro is cartilage, sarcoma is malignancy. Okay, so sarcoma matlab malignancy, chondro matlab cartilage. So it is a malignant cell tumor of cartilage cells. Okay, now we'll go ahead and then we'll see. So this chondrosarcoma, so I had make it resemblance with Counter Strike. I don't know how many people know this game. So Counter Strike is a very famous game for hostilites. Okay, so if Counter Strike is chondrosarcoma, okay, so see this kid. Okay, they see this kid having popcorn. Okay, he's sitting like this. He's on sitting like couch on this. Okay, so this type of coma shape kaisa baithta hai. So they are playing games like for 12 hours, 14 hours. So they are playing like coma shaped game. Okay, popcorn hota hai. Okay, now because of long sitting. Okay, because of the long sitting, the main issue of the main problem comes to the pelvis area. Okay, because the games makes you sit for 8 hours, 10 hours. Okay, so we'll again start with, so malignancy is from cartilage cells. Okay, this is very thick. Now, this is something which is fourth to fifth decade. So, it's not very common in young children. So, this you should remember. It is for elder people. Okay. Elder. Okay. So, people who play games think they are very elder or mature type. So, they are in the fourth, fifth decade. Elderly people move those. So, pelvis is the most common involvement. I will show you how pelvis affected. So, pelvis is the most common because you sit on for the games for a long period on your pelvis. Okay. Now, it can be diaphysis and metaphysis. I don't know. It is a gradually enlarging mass. Okay, so diaphysis, metaphysis, you have to see on with mnemonic that in which category it falls. So you just remember this face. Okay, popcorn sitting like a comma. Okay, comma shape sitting. Okay, so this is the chondrosarcoma. So you see this whole pelvis. Okay, this whole pelvis has gone. Okay, this whole pelvis ka ye sara destroyed ho jata hai because it's a very big tumor. Chondrosarcoma is a big tumor. Bahut bada bada tumor hota hai. Big size tumors hota hai chondrosarcoma. Cartilaginous tumor hota hai. Okay? Mainly pelvis affected. Okay. So you see this now classification of most importance of this is you have punctate comma shape. So the child sitting like comma. Okay. So comma shape calcification or you have a popcorn calcification. The kid is eating popcorn. So comma or popcorn shape calcification. Okay. You have to remember this word, endosteal scalloping. What do you mean by endosteal scalloping? Okay, so we'll learn it very well. So end means, osteal means bone. Okay, end means the end of the bones. Okay, so if you see this bone, aisa ye jo marking hai na, so this is cortex. Okay, ye cortex hai. Okay, so in the cortex, this type of event. Okay, so this type of event, halka sa ye. ऐसा होता है सो दिस टाइप ऑफ इवेंट ओके ये ऐसा ऐसा सो इसको बोलते हैं एंडोस्टियल स्कैलोपिंग ओके क्या बोलते हैं एंडोस्टियल सो ये जो एंडोस्टियम था ये अंदर का जो ऑस्टियम है इसको स्कैलोपिंग कर रहा है स्कैलोपिंग मतलब खाना इसको खा जा रहा है ऐसा सो सी दिस इज द क्लासिकल पिक्चर ऑफ स्कैलोपिंग ओके सो आई हैड पुट दिस टू रिमेंबर व्हाट इज स्कैलोपिंग सो दिस स्कैलोपिंग इज अंदर से ऐसा खा जाता है ओके सो एंडोस्टियल स्कैलोपिंग इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ this tumor found chondrosarcoma so people who play games unko ye andar tak ye kha jata hai this games okay. So endosteal scalloping you should remember if you don't remember the mnemonic at least you should remember endosteal scalloping is a part of chondrosarcoma okay this is medullary cavity you see this radiolucent lesion so radiolucent lesion endosteal scalloping okay comma shaped popcorn shaped calcification endosteal scalloping chondrosarcoma matlab counter strike treatment surgery okay so again we'll see and so see this chondrosarcoma malignancy elderly people who okay pelvis most commonly involved gradually enlarging mass you see this is the kid popcorn calcification comma shape ka ye baithta hai okay comma shape baithta hai itka brain is the brain अंदर तक खा जाता है दिस गेम सो इट इज एंडोस्टियल स्कैलोपिंग ओके गेम को अंदर तक खा जाता है एंडोस्टियल स्कैलोपिंग इज देयर ओके दिस इज द ट्यूमर ओके यू सी दिस ट्यूमर देन पेल्विस इज द मोस्ट कॉमन एरिया ओके जिस पे लॉन्ग सिटिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रोसार्कोमा बिकॉज ऑफ दिस काउंटर स्ट्राइक गेम दिस हैपेंस ओके सो दिस पंक्टेट सेल्फ कैल्सिफिकेशन popcorn calcification endosteal scalloping this medullary cavity mein there is a radiolucent lesion because cartilaginous tumor so any cartilaginous tumor you have this black part okay black part dikhta hai cartilaginous tumor treatment surgery okay. Now what is secondary chondrosarcoma so chondrosarcoma matlab cartilage sarcoma means malignancy so cartilage ka koi bhi malignancy is chondrosarcoma what is secondary chondrosarcoma if there is a primary chondrotumor means primary मतलब benign कोई भी cartilaginous tumor है and in the meantime उसको मन किया कि now I have to turn into malignancy so that is a form of secondary chondrosarcoma so what is primary chondrosarcoma मतलब the patient has from starting it have chondrosarcoma the cells differentiated into chondrosarcoma secondary chondrosarcoma मतलब पहले उसको कोई benign lesion था cartilaginous का कोई benign tumor था like enchondroma osteochondroma ye sab benign tumors hai and later on they have like 5% risk tha malignancy mein and they turn into some malignant tumor so enchondroma I had already told you ye phalanges mein hota hai osteochondroma matlab exostosis hota hai jo 18 के अंदर फ्यूज होता है. सो दीज आर द बेनाइन कार्टिलेजनस ट्यूमर. इनको बहुत सालों बाद मन किया कि नाउ वी हैव टू टर्न इनटू सम मैलिग्नेंसी. तो कॉन्ड्रोट कार्टिलेज है, मैलिग्नेंसी में हुआ, सो इट टर्न्स इनटू कॉन्ड्रोसार्कोमा. सो इट इज अ सेकेंडरी कॉन्ड्रोसार्कोमा. ओलियर्स मैफूसीज, आई हेट मफिन्स, सो हेट का मफिन्स का हेट डाल देंगे. ओके, नाउ गो अहेड. ओके, नाउ दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो दिस इज फाइब्रस डिस्प्लेसिया. ओके, सो दिस इज अ, व्हाट यू मीन बाय एनाप्लेसिया, मेटाप्लेसिया, डिस्प्लेसिया. ओके, सो मेटाप्लेसिया मतलब क्या होता है? वन सेल कन्वर्टेड इनटू अदर सेल. ओके, वन सेल कन्वर्टेड इनटू अदर सेल इज अ मेटाप्लेसिया. एनाप्लेसिया इज द लॉस ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन, वेयर एवरीथिंग इज लॉस्ट, लाइक टोटली ट्यूमर, मतलब टोटली नियोप्लाज्म इज एनाप्लेसिया. डिस्प्लेसिया इज where there is a distortion of the alignment. Okay, so dis matlab distortion. So alignment, jo cells ke alignment ka distortions hota hai, jahan cells aligned hota hai, aisa cells agar aligned hai normal, agar iska alignment mein distortion ho jata hai, okay, so that is known as dysplasia. So it is a fibrous dysplasia. So normally kya hota hai, the bones mein kya hota hai, andar normally cancellous bones hote hai andar, theek hai. Ye jo cancellous bone hai na, ye remove hot ke because of the डिस्प्लास्टिक चेंजेस, डिस्प्लास्टिक मतलब बिकॉज ऑफ डिस्टॉर्शन, एंड इधर फाइब्रस सारे हो जाते हैं, ये सारा फाइब्रस हो जाता है. दिस बोन कन्वर्टेड इनटू फाइब्रस टिश्यू. सो बोनी टिश्यू कन्वर्टेड इनटू फाइब्रस टिश्यू इज फाइब्रस डिस्प्लेसिया. इट्स अ टाइप ऑफ डिस्प्लेसिया वेयर बोन कन्वर्टेड इनटू फाइब्रस टिश्यू. ठीक है, रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ नॉर्मल कैंसलस बोन बाय फाइब्रस टिश्यू इज नोन एज फाइब्रस डिस्प्लेसिया. सो इट कैन बी टू टाइप्स, इट कैन बी अफेक्टिंग वन बोन, इट कैन अफेक्ट मेनी बोन्स. So you should remember only one dictum. Okay, so if any disease affecting all of the body, okay, or multiple bone or multiple system, it should be like a syndromic. Okay, so syndrome का मतलब क्या होता है? बहुत सारे systems को, बहुत सारे bones को एक साथ affect करते हैं. So whenever you have some type of disease which is multiple, so polyostotic मतलब many bones are affected. Okay, so they are usually affected in childhood. Okay, so मल्टीपल अफेक्शन इन द चाइल्डहुड. तो चाइल्डहुड में क्या होता है? बहुत सारे होते हैं. सो पॉलीओस्टोटिक इज मेनी बोन्स एंड लेस देन 10 इयर्स. सो इट इज वेरी चाइल्डहुड. मोनोस्टोटिक का क्या मतलब होता है? वन बोन इज अफेक्टेड और लेटर ऑफ द एज में होता है. तो ये यंग होता है. पॉलीओस्टोटिक इज यंग, ये थोड़ा लेट होता है. पॉलीओस्टोटिक मैग्जिला में होता है, ये फीमर में होता है. आई विल टेल हाउ टू रिमेम्बर मैग्जिला फीमर. सो गो अहेड. So this is very important syndrome. You have studied in pathology, but obviously you did not give a stress on that. So McCune-Albright syndrome bolta hai. Okay. So if you go into policing or IPS officers, okay, so many of the bright student of MBBS go to become IPS, crack UPSC, then become DCP. So DCP is it? I think. Deputy Commissioner of Police. Okay, so every bright student go for DCP. So DCP बनते हैं. So McCune-Albright syndrome is bright syndrome. So bright syndrome DCP. So what happens in DCP is one is fibrous dysplasia. So D for going for dysplasia. C going for cephalot lesion. What is cephalot lesion? And you are not study skin. So cephalot lesion क्या होता है? ये cephalot cephalate. So it's like a coffee. Okay, so coffee color ka cafe latte hota hai. So you see this one, it's coffee color skin discoloration. Okay, so cafe latte bolte, cafe latte bolte. So you have a coffee color skin discoloration hota hai body mein. So isko cafe latte spots bolte hai. Fibrous dysplasia is a part of tumor, and there is a precocious puberty. Precocious puberty means young age mein puberty ka aa jana. So before like 13 ka hai, to normally 10-9 mein hai, that is precocious puberty. So in Albright syndrome, there is three things. One is fibrous dysplasia. So the child is bright, so he will become DCP. The child is bright, so he will turns into early puberty. So precocious puberty ho gaya. Okay. Cephalot lesions hoga. Okay. So coffee is good for bright students. So cephalot lesions hoga. And fibrous dysplasia is a part of tumor. So see this guy. Okay. So this guy, you see the maxilla. Okay. See the maxilla. So see, this is a syndromic child. Because why it is a syndromic child? Because you see maxilla, you see eyes, you see the forehead, you see his body posture. So everything is affected. So see, the maxilla is still malleable. So if you remember this face is syndromic face. So it is a polyostotic. polyostotic type of fibrous dysplasia, and you see the maxilla is affected mainly. So in maxilla is affected in polyostotic, and obviously femur is sabka bap femur. So femur will be in monostotic. Okay. So polyostotic association is, you have this Albright syndrome, and one more syndrome is Major-Broad syndrome, myxoma. Don't remember that. Okay. So this, see, the important of fibrous dysplasia kya hota hai? I will show you. So what happens in fibrous dysplasia? Ye aapka femur hai, okay? So this is your femur, this is your neck, okay? This is your neck and this is your body, okay? So what happens? Abhi ye bone jo hai, this bone ke jagah yahan fibrous tissue ho jata hai. So normally what is the importance of bone? So bone kya hota hai? Bone will give you a structural support, okay? So your weight comes on your femur and bone will usually give you structural support to stand. If it is a fibrous, ye sara fibrous ho jata hai. Because it's already become fibrous na. So now because of fibrous, it is like it can be bow down, or it can be, what you say, it is malleable. Okay, so ye kya hota hai? Because of the structural, as soon as the weight you start putting on your femur, the femur will turn into like this. So your head will become this, neck will become this, and this will become this. Okay, so ye pura aisa ghum jata hai. So it will turn like this. Okay, it will turn like this. Okay, I will show you what it turns like. So this is the your position of your femur. Okay, so you see your femur become like a shepherd crook deformity. So a shepherd jo hote hain unke ye chhadi hote hain. So your femur will become like this, chhadi ki tarah ban jata hai. Why it become like this? Because the bone is replaced by the fibrous tissue, and your fibrous tissue cannot withstand your body weight. So it turns into this shepherd crook deformity. Okay, so shepherd crook deformity or ground glass deformity for that. So it turns into the shepherd crook deformity in fibrous dysplasia. It is also known as ground glass appearance. Why it is known as ground glass appearance? If you see this, this is very look like ground glass. Aisa clear dikhta hai, theek hai? Like as a, because there is no bone. Okay, so bone kya hota hai? Bone khatam ho jata hai. Sab jagah fibrous tissue ho jata hai. So it will be like radiolucent ho jata hai. Aar paar dikhta hai. Because bone is radio opaque, so bone kya karta hai? If you pass X-ray, bone will prevent your X-ray. If there is no bone, there is no opacity. Okay, so everything will become lucent. Okay, dono side dikhega. So it will become ground glass. So you remember that thing. Ground glass matlab dono side dikhega. There is no bone, so it is a part of fibrous dysplasia. Shepherd Cook deformity ho jayega. There is one more sign, rind sign. Okay, this rind sign. So this is a thick sclerotic bone dikhta hai yahan pe, thick layer of thick sclerotic bone dikhta hai yahan pe. This is the rind sign. Okay, I try to make some mnemonic, but I cannot. I don't know how you will remember this. So, but rind sign is part of fibrous dysplasia. Okay, if you don't remember, it's also okay. So it is a thick sclerotic bone. Sara bone turns ho jata hai fibrous mein, dono side aar paar dikhta hai, but some sort of bone may be sclerotic, which is known as a rind sign. Remember it the way you want to remember it. Okay, so what is the treatment? So see, your bone is turning into fibrous tissue. Now you have to turn the fibrous tissue into bone. So bisphosphonate. So bisphosphonate ka kya kaam hota hai? It helps in calcium reabsorption and osteoporosis mein hum log bisphosphonates dete hain. So if you give bisphosphonates, the calcium will be absorbed into your bone and it will become more of the bone. Okay. So normally we will start with bisphosphonate therapy. Okay, agar fracture ho gaya, obviously if there is a fracture, then you have to do curettage bone graft and internal fixation. So fracture ho gaya, then you have to fix it. Okay, you have to curettage whole of the bone and put bone graft. Bone graft is for structural support. Curettage is jahan bhi wo fibrous tissue hai usko nikal dene ka, jahan bhi fibrous tissue usko nikalne ka, uske andar bone dalne ka, and you have to fix it. Okay. We have a case in the hospital. Okay. I did not shown you that time. There was a case in our hospital. Okay, so again we'll discuss this so that it will be stuck in your mind. So fibrous dysplasia, it is a form of a dysplasia where bone ko fibrous tissue mein convert kar deta hai. ठीक है पहला चीज. Polyostotic means multiple bones. Young children rahega, syndromic hota hai. We have seen one phase, there is a syndromic phase. So maxilla obviously most common. The other thing is monostotic, femur 20 to 30 years. Albright, every bright student go for DCP. Every bright student drink coffee, precocious puberty because they are bright. Fibrous dysplasia is a bad part of that. Okay, so it is a DCP. This three, this is cephalot spot. Okay. Now this polyostotic association is a McCune-Albright syndrome and Majerbot syndrome. Okay, so these two things more. Sheppard-Cook deformity because cannot withstand your pressure. Since the bone is replaced by the fibrous tissue, it will show like a ground glass appearance. Okay. Rind sign, I don't know how to remember. Treatment, calcium dalo usme, so wash bisphosphonate. If by chance there is a fracture, so obviously if there is a fracture, you have to fix that. Okay. So you remove, you can attach the whole bone tumor tissue, put bone graft for structural support, internally fix it. Okay. Now we'll start with adamantinoma. Okay, so adamantinoma is something, which is a different type of tumor. Okay. So what is, there is a type of epithelium. So there is many type of epithelium. There is one type of epithelium which is known as amylo epithelium, adamantine epithelium. You have never heard of this word, but we'll start with this. So there is an epithelium which is known as adamantine epithelium. उस एपिथीलियम सेल का कुछ इश्यू होता है जिसके कारण एक ट्यूमर होता है, दैट इज नोन एज एडमेंटिनोमा. ओके, इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ वन ट्यूमर. सो एक जॉ में एक ट्यूमर होता है. सो सी दिस दिस गाइस, देयर इज अ जॉ में एक ट्यूमर है इसके. दिस तो नॉर्मली बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एपिथीलियम, सो देयर इज अ एपिथीलियम, सो एडमेंटाइन एपिथीलियम बोलता है. ये बहुत ही एडमेंट एपिथीलियम है, स्टबर्न एपिथीलियम है. ओके, इसलिए एडमेंटाइन बोलते हैं इसको. सो इफ इट अकर्स इन जॉ, अगर वो ही उसका ट्यूमर जॉ में होता है, सो इसको बोलते हैं एमिलोब्लास्टोमा. सो दिस ट्यूमर इन जॉ इज नोन एन एमिलोब्लास्टोमा. द सेम ट्यूमर इन लॉन्ग बोन्स, ये लॉन्ग बोन्स में अगर वो होता है तो उसको हम लोग बोलते हैं एडमेंटिनोमा. सो एमिलोब्लास्टोमा एंड एडमेंटिनोमा आर द सेम. इट्स लाइक योर निक नेम एंड योर कॉलेज नेम. ओके, सो इफ यू आर इन एट योर होम, यू विल बी कॉल्ड बाय योर निक नेम्स. इफ यू आर गोइंग टू योर कॉलेज, यू विल कॉल्ड बाय योर फैंसी नेम. सो इट्स, सो एमिलोब्लास्टोमा एंड एडमेंटिनोमा बोथ आर same. Okay, depending upon the location, so even if you pronounce both, it will look same. Amyloblastoma and adamantinoma both have milo amantinoma. Okay, so adamantinoma and amyloblastoma matlab ye this negro with jaw, adamantinoma matlab long bone. Okay, so it is a male officer, so I think diaphysis. Okay, so diaphysis is the, now we'll go ahead. So see this see in the jaw tumor. So we'll discuss for amyloblastoma. So this ye jo aisa circular aata hai. So this, see this, this is a very much of bubble shape. So yahan pe kya hota hai, jaw mein kya hota hai, this all circular bubble shape hota hai. So bubble appearance hota hai. This appearance also occur in GCT. So in GCT may be ye hota hai, so bubble appearance also in amyloblastoma. Bubble like effect hota, so it's like a bubble like effect hota. Okay, so this is amyloblastoma. Aomyloblast karte hai. I don't know why I put this. Aomyloblast karte. So you remember this guy, this negro, this is amyloblastoma. Okay, so giant cell tumors hote hain isme, so bubble appearance hota hai iska, crackling effect, theek hai, lytic lesion hota hai. Okay. So I think we'll stop for this and we'll again continue after. There's only 2-3 cells. So amyloblastoma, you just again remember this. So bubble appearance, bubble life effect, lytic lesion, demarcated lytic lesion. Okay. Sclerotic rim. Okay. Yes, sab theek hai. Mixed in fibrous sclerotic rim hota hai, theek hai. So second to third decade. Okay. Amyloblastoma. Okay. So we'll, it's going to be finished in 2 minutes.